example, government procurement. Right now, the secretary of DVM considers himself to be father of the current procurement law, which is a model law. And he said at a forum 2 weeks ago I attended that he didn't want to see it amended because he thought the members of the House would exempt the LGUs, their home districts or their home provinces, from these national laws, possibly to the detriment of how money is spent, because in fact, the money does come from the central government here to the local governments, and I think they'll still, under federalism, the national government, federal government would retain that same leverage. But all these 30,000, they're mostly administrative rather than laws. I was going to make a comment that I may be wrong on this, and again, I'd like, Mirna, I'm not talking about Down Under here with New Zealand or Australia, I'm asking about Malaysia again, but my concept of that certain ASEAN countries can move very quickly to change things like investment incentives. Here, the Philippines has been trying to change some investment incentives, fiscal incentives, since they were proposed in 1995 by the Department of Finance. My impression is Prime Minister Raza can, in a cabinet meeting in the morning, ask his fellow ministers to do something in the National Assembly in the afternoon and it could be implemented the following week. Here we have an example of something taking 20 years. What are some of the lessons looking around the region? I'm not advocating any particular form of democracy or single party rule, but there are some advantages and disadvantages of how it works.